In this problem, if you have observed the last of the last position like this, this is actually isometric projection of a cube with three axes, the three axes, and those axes are equally spaced 120 degree to each other. Angle between any two axes is 120 degree. And another thing that you can observe is base edges are making 30 degree to the horizontal line. You can see this video clip how isometric view is obtained for a cube. This is how it is obtained, and these three planes are called isometric planes. The corner three is lifted up so that three gets in the front view, and you obtain this isometric view. Now in the next slide, we'll understand what is isometric. ISO word meaning is equal. The metric is measurement. So it is together, it is equal measurement. What is this equal measurement that we'll try to understand now? So consider the isometric view of a cube, as I explained in the previous slide. And you can see the three axes, 1, 2, and 3. These three axes are called principal isometric axes. Angle between any two axes is 120 degree, and we can call them as x, y, z. And the base edges are making 30 degree to horizontal. That is another observation. With this, you can see two parallel lines which are shown in white color. They are parallel to x axis. They are parallel to x axis. And other two lines which are shown in yellow color, you can see these two lines. They are parallel to y-axis, and two vertical edges which are visible, they are parallel to z-axis. And with this, we'll just try to understand the properties of isometric projection. The very first property is principal axis, as shown x, y, z. They form 120 degree angles to each other, and any edge along any line along those axes called as isometric line. Any edge along the principal isometric axis is called isometric line. Any other edge or line is called non-isometric line. For example, if you join the opposite corners of any face, that becomes a non-isometric line because that line is not parallel to any of the axes. Whereas all the edges of the cube actually parallel to any one of the axes. They are all isometric lines. You know that when a line is inclined to any plane, corresponding view will be shortened. It will not be seen in the true length. And in isometric, it can be mathematically proved that any line which is parallel to isometric axis is reduced by 0.8164 times the actual length. So now in this view, whatever I have shown, if the actual length is 50 mm, then in isometric view, all the edges are reduced by 0.8164 into 50. So much reduction happen because they are all inclined actually. They are not parallel to the projecting plane. This is another thing that you need to remember. In isometric projection, any line we are representing on any of the three principal axes has to be shortened by 0.8164 times the actual length. Parallel lines in orthographic projection remains parallel in isometric projection also. You just imagine a cube. If you draw the top view and front view, it will become square shape in both the views, and two edges are parallel to each other, and the same edges will be parallel to each other in the isometric view also. That is another property. And in orthographic projection, if two edges are vertical, they remain vertical in the isometric view also. Edges shown in red color, they are vertical. With these properties, you can write that which is actually seen as a rhombus in the isometric. You can see the top face of the cube that is projected, that is actually a rhombus, but in actual size it is a square. Similarly, if I create an isometric view of a rectangle, it looks like a parallelogram. If I draw the isometric view of a circle, it looks like an ellipse. These are some of the fundamentals that you need to remember for drawing isometric projections. Next, I said any line parallel to any of the principal axis is reduced by 81.6% of the true length, or 0.8164 times the actual length. How do we construct isometric projections when true length is known? So every time we cannot multiply true length with 0.8164 using calculator and use it. So in order to obtain the isometric lengths, there is a graphical construction that you can do. This figure shows the isometric scale. And how to construct this is, first you have to draw the horizontal line, right? Then you draw another line which is at 30 degree to horizontal. The second red line that going now is a line which is inclined at 30 degree to the initial line. Draw one more line at 45 degree to the horizontal. Now whatever you measure on this line, 45 degree line, that is actually true length or true dimension of the object or length. This is true dimension. Now if I want the isometric length corresponding to any value here, I just have to draw a vertical line from that point, and whatever distance I get from here to here is a isometric length. For example, if I want isometric length for 50 mm, so you measure 50 mm along this and drop a vertical line like this downward, and wherever it meets this 30 degree line from that point to the origin, if you measure, that is the isometric length. Now you can see black dark line shows the isometric length corresponding to 5 units in the true length. So this construction you need to do, because from this diagram only you will measure the isometric length and use it in your construction. So this is called isometric scale that we need to construct. This is a cube represented in 3 dimension. Now if I consider this as x axis, this as y axis, and vertical outward line as z axis. This is in 3 dimension. I am imagining origin at the corner which is invisible here, and this is x axis, this is y axis, and this is z axis. Now if I see from top and try to draw the top view in orthographic projection, looks like this, right? Top face is visible like this, and in this view I'll call this axis as x and this axis as y. This is the xy plane. You can see xy plane is here, top face is parallel to xy plane. This can be xy plane here, and if I see in this direction for the front view, I can see this face which is a square again, that will come here. So front view is a square, and the plane on which this front view is drawn now is zx plane. This is x axis, this is z axis. So this is how we capture the orthographic views of an dimension object. In creating any isometric projection or view, you have to draw a horizontal line first. So I'm drawing the horizontal line, you can see. Then I have to draw a line this direction, in this direction at 30 degree to horizontal, which I'm calling it as x axis. You can see this is the x axis I'm drawing. It is at 30 degree to horizontal, and other edge on this side at 30 degree again to the horizontal. I'm drawing y axis like this. So this much construction you have to do in order to start any problem in isometric. This is considered to be x axis, this is considered to be y axis, or you can swap also. This can be y, it can be x also. And where is z axis? Z axis will be vertical like this. Z axis will be vertical, but actually in one of the slide I showed this as x axis, this as y axis, and z axis as this. But now I am using upward direction, because we always start creating the object from the base. We create the base first, then we give the height for that. So this is my z axis. Now you can imagine the plane formed by x axis and y axis. This is a plane. Plane means it is infinite, but I am representing it using a box like this. So this is called xy plane or horizontal plane in isometric view. Now if I take z axis and x axis, I can construct a plane like this. This is called right side vertical plane or z x plane. Similarly, I can consider a plane with x z direction also, like this. This is called z y plane or left side vertical plane. So there are three planes now: horizontal plane formed by x y axis, vertical plane formed by z x, and vertical plane formed by z y. Now we'll try to understand how we draw the isometric view of a cube. First, as I told you, we have to draw the horizontal line, then a line for y axis at 30 degree to horizontal. From the same point, I have to draw another axis, x axis, at 30 degree to horizontal, like this. Now I should construct the bottom face of the cube. You know that bottom face of a cube is a square. Suppose if the true length of this edge is 50 mm, I have to go to isometric scale 50 and draw a line and get this dimension. So this is actually isometric 50. This is actual 50 mm, but this is isometric 50. This will be 0.8164 times the actual 50, or 0.8164 into 50. So this is what I need to represent here. Always in isometric view, I have to represent the isometric lens, not the true lens. So I have to draw here. Can you recognize this white line here? That is actually isometric of 50 mm. It is isometric 50 or ISO 50. It is not actual 50. So one side I have drawn. Next, I can draw the other side of the square along this axis, x axis. This is along y axis. Another side, perpendicular side here, along the x axis. How much length? The same length, because that is also 50 mm. ISO 50 is equal to this much length. The same length you take on the other axis, you draw this line. So I have drawn two edges of the square. This is not the face now. I have drawn only two edges of the bottom face. I have to complete this. I have to use one more property, which says actual object, if two lines are parallel, if two edges are parallel, they are parallel in isometric also. So what I can do is I can make use of this property and draw a line from this point, like this, parallel to x axis, like this. See, this line is parallel to this axis, because in actual object also these two are parallel. I have drawn this side along these two. This side I am trying to draw, which is parallel to this. So I have to draw a line parallel to this axis. Then I have to draw this line. So I have to start from this point and draw like this, which is parallel to this axis, y axis. So it will be like this. So this is how you construct the bottom face of the cube. Second stage is constructing the height for this. Now I have taken the bottom face on xy plane. So height should be along z axis, because height is perpendicular to the base. What is the height? It is equal to the size of the cube, which is 50 mm, let us say. 50 mm isometric I should take now. Isometric length of 50 mm is this much. And I have to draw vertical line from all these four corners, because there are vertical edges from all the four corners. So first line is drawn here. What is this? This is ISO 50 mm drawn from this point. Next, this line. This is ISO 50 drawn from this point. And it has to coincide with this, because these four sides are equal. It will be automatically at this point. Next, ISO 50 from this corner, give the height here, and one more is from this corner, like this. Now I have constructed height, or I have given the height for all the base corners. So all these four sides are of length ISO 50. Next step is to draw the top face. How do we draw the top face now? Top face is parallel to bottom face, and it is nothing but the plane or the face which is formed by joining these corner of face corners. See, I already got these four corners. I have to join them to create this face. So I'll draw lines joining those top edges to make it a face. So this is the top face now. We started with the bottom face. We constructed bottom face. We have given the height for all the corners, and top faces we joined and we got the top face. Now this is the isometric view of the cube, but I don't have to show the invisible edges in isometric. So all these lines are to be drawn thin initially. Then you have to darken the visible edges at the end. So fourth step is darkening the visible edges. Now in this position, in isometric view, top face will be visible because the visible corner is lifted up. So top face has to be visible. So you darken the top face first. So I have darkened this top face now. This is visible. This edge has to be visible. This edge is in the front, that has to be visible. And this is also visible. So three vertical edges are visible and the fourth vertical edge will not be visible because it is covered by this face. Face covers that edge, that is not visible. So these three lines you can darken. So I have darkened these three lines. Remaining two lines are these edges which are in the front. They are also visible. I have to darken them also. Now this is the isometric view of cube where this line or this edge and this edge are not visible in the isometric view, but you don't have to erase them. You can leave it as thin lines. They are required in order to understand how you have constructed. Don't erase it. But in actual isometric view, those lines are not required. Only the visible edges you can represent. Then you can see this animation, how isometric view of a cube becomes a hexagon like this. This is the last position front view of that cube with a solid diagonal perpendicular to VP. This is how it is obtained. And in other video, you can see if I place cube on a cube of different size with axis to axis coincidence, how does it look like in the isometric view? It looks like this. A smaller cube is placed on a bigger cube with axis to axis coincidence. In isometric view, it looks like this. See, hidden edges are not seen. This is isometric view. So these type of problems will be given in the examination. The combination of solids. It can be any combination. It can be a prism, cone combination, pyramid, on a cylinder, anything. Initially, we'll start with simple two-dimensional objects. The isometric projection of a rectangle of size 60 mm into 30 mm. Initial step is to create isometric scale. Construct isometric scale now. In order to construct isometric scale, first I have to draw a horizontal line. Draw a horizontal line. Then I should measure 30 degree here. 0, 10, 20, 30. And another line is required at 45 degrees. So 30, 40, 45 here. And I'll draw two lines here from this point. One is 30 degree line and other one is 45 degree line. This is 30 degree line and this is 45 degree line. Line is actually ISO scale or ISO line, and this line is actually the true length or actual scale. So this is actual scale, this is ISO scale. Now I'll make few markings on this actual scale. First is 0, 0 is here, 10 mm, 20 mm, 30 mm, 40 mm, 50 mm, 60 mm, 70 mm and so on. This actual length from here, this is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. So 60 is here and 30 is here. Now I have to get the isometric CMM. So I have to draw a vertical line from here. I'll make use of this. I'll keep this edge parallel to horizontal line and use other edge to draw the vertical line. From 60, I want to draw a vertical line like this and it should meet this 30 degree ISO scale. So I'm drawing vertical line like this. Like this. Now what is this? From here to here, it is ISO 60. From this point to this point, now if I measure, that is a ISO 60. In order to start the isometric projection, we'll start with the horizontal line first. Horizontal line I'm drawing. And on this horizontal line, at any point, maybe approximately the midpoint, you mark a point and draw 30 degree line on either side. Here, from 30 degree here, from here 30 degree here, I'll draw two lines on either side like this. I'll mark this angle also. See, it's 30 degree. Is also 30 degree. You can call this as x axis or y axis. This naming is not required actually, but for your understanding I am writing now. Now I can draw the isometric projection of the rectangle on any of the plane. I can draw it on xy plane, or I can draw it vertically on zx plane, or I can draw it on the left vertical plane, that is yz plane also. I can draw it anywhere. We will try to draw on all three different planes now. We will understand how to construct them in different planes. First, we'll consider xy plane. So if I draw rectangle like this, if I draw a rectangle like this, and if I consider this as origin 0 0 and this as x axis, this as y axis. Now actual length here is 60 mm, let us say, and actual of the rectangle is 30 mm, let us say. Now I want to represent this length here on x axis with origin here. See, this is the actual origin, but in isometric origin. I want to draw this length along x axis, along this length. But I cannot draw actual 60 mm here because it is reduced here. So what I should do? I should go to isometric scale for 60 mm. I should measure what is isometric length, and that length I should represent here. So I'll do that now. I'll use compass. I'll measure this. Measure this. This is isometric 60, and I'll mark it from this point. This is the, so this is isometric 60. This is the point. So I took this point here, this point here. Now, in order to draw this point is along y-axis. Y-axis means this axis, but this length is 30 mm. So I should measure ISO 30 from here and take that length and represent here. Actual 30 is here. And I should draw a vertical line there. I'll keep this edge parallel to this and draw a vertical line like this. Yeah, I have drawn a vertical line there. And this is the length that you need to measure now and transfer it here. Measure. So from this origin on the other side, I want to transfer it like this. So I have drawn this edge. I have drawn this edge. Two edges are drawn. This is the first edge, 60 mm edge, and this is the other edge. I'm not darkening those edges now. In the end, you have to darken the edges. So I have drawn these two. Now I want to draw this edge, let us say. Now I said a property, if two lines are parallel, in isometric also, it will be parallel. That means this edge, if I want to draw now, that edge is parallel to this edge. Right? So this edge is already drawn. And this edge starts from this point, which is here. So I have to draw a line now like this, parallel to this. I have to draw a line like this, parallel to this. For drawing parallel line, what I will do is keep the scale and try square like this. See, this edge is coincident with the x-axis now. Now I'll keep the scale as it is and slide this square till that point. And now I'll draw a line like this, a thin line I'm drawing. So this is a line parallel to x-axis now. On that line, this is the length, this is 60 mm, I know, right? ISO 60, I can take and cut it. The best way is, you draw the other line also. I have drawn a line, don't measure the length now. You draw this line, this edge is parallel to this edge. Means, I have to draw a line from this point, like this, parallel to this edge. Keep this, and slide this, till this point, and draw this line. Those two lines intersect now. You can see this point. That is this point. So this point automatically we got by drawing two parallel lines. Now you can darken this. I'll darken this. Yeah. This is the isometric view of the rectangle that is required. Now while constructing this, I can swap between these two also. I can make this as 30, this as 60. If I reverse that, what will happen? 30 mm, this much length will come here and this length will go here. So I'll get a view like this. These are possibility. Both are solutions on xy plane. Let us try to construct the same rectangle on at x plane, let us say. I'll draw a horizontal line first. Now at any convenient location, you can mark the origin, 30 degree line from here to this. Let us say this is the x axis now. But I want to draw this rectangle on x, z plane. So I don't have to draw the other axis. I straight away draw the vertical axis. I'll draw the vertical line like this. Yeah. This is z axis. Rectangle, what consider it in x, z plane now. Same rectangle. This is 60 mm. This is 30 mm. Now this is the origin. This is x axis. And I'll take this as z axis now, because I want to represent this in that x, z plane now. As we did here, we have to represent this length here on x axis, and we have to represent this length on z axis now. Then draw parallel lines. We represent this length ISO 60, so this much. Actual 60 is here. Draw a vertical line, and this is ISO 60. That length you measure and draw here. So I'll draw that now. And ISO 30, the other edge, other perpendicular edge is 30 mm. So ISO 30 you take, and on z axis you measure like this. You got the point here. So this edge and this edge is drawn now. And this edge I have to draw, which is parallel to this. So I have to draw a line from this point parallel to x axis. Similarly, if I want to draw this edge, which is parallel to z axis, so from this point, parallel to z-axis, I should draw. So wherever they intersect, I get a point, which is this point. Take the scale and tri-square like this, and slide this tri-square. And at this point, I draw this line. Similarly, slide this here and draw a vertical line. Wherever those two lines intersect, that is this point, is nothing but this point. So highlight it. This is the isometric view of rectangle in z-axis plane. So I have taken 60 here and 30 here, right? 60, 30. If I swap, I will get 30 here and 60 here, and draw parallel lines like this, you get this. This is another possibility. You can keep the face like this also. This is the first solution. This is the second solution. Any other on x-z plane. Now the same rectangle, can you construct on YZ plane, and we have to draw 30 degree line this side and measure 30 mm ISO 30 or ISO 60. If I want ISO 60 here, I can mark here, and ISO 30 on this axis, and from there draw parallel line and another parallel line here, and darken this. That becomes the isometric view of the rectangle on YZ plane. Or if you want to take ISO 30 this side, becomes like this. Now I want to draw isometric view of this triangle. Triangle, one of the side length is given 30 mm, and two inclinations are given. Left side inclination is 45 degree and right side inclination is 60 degree. In order to construct isometric view of these kind of sketches, now I can take this as x-axis, but where axis, if I take here, this side is parallel to x-axis, I can easily recognize, but this edge is not parallel to this axis or this axis. So this becomes non-isometric line. Even this edge, it is not parallel to any of the reference axis. That is also non-isometric edge. So I cannot directly construct these two edges. But what we can do is, we can enclose this corner like this by drawing a horizontal line passing through this corner and draw a vertical line from this point, this. So I'm enclosing the triangle inside a rectangle. Now I can draw this rectangle, isometric rectangle, you know how to draw it. Draw horizontal line, construct 30 degree line 45 degree line, 30 degree line, 45 degree line, and on 45 degree line I'll mark actual lengths. I want 10, 20, 30, 40, let us say 50. These are actual lengths. I want ISO 30 first. So I should measure 30 here and draw a vertical line. I'll keep this edge parallel to horizontal and draw this vertical line. I try to draw only on XY plane now. You can try with ZX plane and ZY plane later. First I draw horizontal line like this. And at any convenient point, you draw 30 degree on either side, 30 degree here, 30 degree here, axis. Like this. So this is X, I can call this as Y. This is origin. Now, this is my X in this view. This is origin. So this point is already here. Now I want to mark this point on this axis. In order to do that, since I want to transfer isometric 30, so measure actual 30 and draw a vertical line, and this is isometric 30. 30 mm. So I got this edge. But I cannot draw this line or this line because they are not isometric lines. But I can make use of this construction and draw this edge. So measure this edge in your actual sketch. To do it separately, I'll draw 30 mm line here, and at this point it is 45 degree, 45 degree, and at this point it is 60 degree, degrees here. This is 60, this is 45, this is 30, this is 45 degree line, this is 60 degree line. This is a given triangle. Now I have to enclose this inside a box. Vertical line and horizontal line from this corner. Like this. Enclose the triangle inside a rectangle. This height I have to measure now. Is approximately 19 mm. 19 mm here, and go to actual scale and mark that 19 mm. So here I am marking 19 mm. That 19 mm marking, I have to draw the vertical line like this. Using compass, I can transfer. So this is the isometric length of the height of the triangle, which I want to mark it here. I have marked it. What is this length? This is the isometric length of this. Then I got this point here. I want to get this point. How do I draw it? I have to draw this line which is parallel to this, and I have to draw this line parallel to this. This is the first parallel line. This is the second parallel line. Now what is this? This is the isometric view of this rectangle. But I want to mark this point. This point, I cannot draw this line and try to draw the point because this is not isometric line. This is also not isometric line. But this distance is isometric. Parallel to x-axis. I have to transfer the isometric length for this distance. This edge is where? It is here. This is that edge. Right? From this point, I should measure this distance on isometric scale, get the isometric length and transfer it here, and to get this point. So I'll do that now. Measuring this distance, and I'm going to isometric scale, approximately 21 mm. I'll draw vertical line there. This is isometric distance, and measure it from here and cut this, get the point here. This is the third corner of the triangle. Two corners are drawn here, and this corner we got it now. So you can join these three to complete the triangle. So this is the isometric view of triangle now. You can take this edge here also. If you take like that, what you will get? You will have edge here. You construct this rectangle. From here, you mark this point. You get it like this. If you want to construct in y plane, you mark the base here and complete the rectangle. From here, you mark the point. You construct it like this. So I cannot get this point directly by using this distance. This is not isometric length. This is not isometric length. But this length is isometric because it is parallel to x-axis. Similarly, you can take from the other end also. From this distance also, from here to here, you can do it. Get the same point. Create the pentagon first, 30 mm size. Enclose the pentagon inside a rectangular box. Now construct the isometric scale. This is actual scale. Ten, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, you mark it on the actual scale. Draw a horizontal line at any convenient point. You draw 30 degree lines on either side. Let us call this as x-axis, this as y-axis, and here in orthographic we'll call this as x-axis, this as y-axis, and this is the origin. Now origin will come here in isometric projection. Let us call this point as P, this as Q, this as R for our convenience, and we'll mark these points as A, B, C, D, E. Now this length is 30 mm you have taken. Now as we did in the case of triangular lamina, we have to construct the isometric projection for this rectangular box first, OPQR. Take the actual length of OP
market on the actual scale, measure this distance, draw it on OX of isometric. This is the point P. Similarly, measure OR, this distance, get the point on the actual scale, draw a vertical line there. This is the ISO length of OR, which has to be drawn on OY axis in isometric. You got point R. Now, in order to complete this box here, we have to draw parallel lines. So keep the edge aligned with the X axis and slide this tri-square such that the new line passes through the point R. So you draw a line like this. This line is parallel to OX. Keep the edge aligned with this. Slide the tri-square and draw the line passing through point P. Now you got the box. This point is Q. Now we have constructed the isometric projection for this rectangle. Now we have to place these points on the rectangle. They are all on the rectangle, for which we have to use these distances. We cannot use any of these distances because they are not isometric lines. Measure OA. This is the isometric length of OA, and remember OA is on OP. So OP is here. So from O you should draw. So I'm marking it here. This is the point A. Now to get point B, we can mark using the same distance from P. So from P means P is here. I'll get point here. So I got point A here, point B here. Now to get point E and C, I have to make use of this distance. This is the isometric length of OE, and remember E is on the line OR. OR is here. So I have to take this distance from O. Isometric length of OE will be drawn here to get the point E, and this distance is equal to this distance, so I can mark point C also on the line PQ. PQ is here. So from P I should measure it. From P mark the point. So I got point E and point C. The only remaining point is D, which is on the line RQ. So measure this distance, go to ISO scale. This is the ISO length of RD. So from R, I will mark here, this point is D. Now you have all the 5 points of the pentagon, join to get the isometric. So this is how we draw the isometric projection of pentagon on the horizontal plane. You can darken these edges. This is the final isometric projection. We can try to draw this pentagon on ZX plane or ZY plane also. Let us draw the Z axis, which is vertical line passing through point O. This is the Z axis. Now whatever the length you have measured along X axis will remain same. These two points will be same. OP also will be same. But this R will come here. E also will come on this line. Similarly, this QCP line will come vertical. So we have to mark point R here first. So let us use the same distance, which is the ISO length of OR on Z axis. If you draw parallel lines there, and a vertical line from point P. You got point Q here and point R here. Now transfer the distance OE, which is actually isometric length of OE, on Z axis. Same distance on this line also to get point C, and this much distance, which is isometric length of RD, on this line to get point D. We got all the points, point C here, point D here, point E here. Now you can join to complete the pentagon. Now this is the isometric projection of pentagon on right vertical plane. First draw the circle of diameter 50, that is radius 25. Enclose this circle inside a box. When we enclose the circle inside a box like this, you can see that this distance is equal to diameter 50, and this will also be equal to diameter 50. So it is actually a square. When we enclose circle inside a box, it becomes a square shape. Construct isometric scale. Draw a horizontal line at any convenient point. You mark 30 degree on either side to draw x and y axis of isometric. 30 degree here, 30 degree here. Now we have to construct the isometric projection of this box. Let us say P, Q, R, S. This box isometric we have to construct, for which we need to calculate what is isometric length of 50. So this is 50 mm. So 50 actually is here. I'm drawing a vertical line passing through 50 mm. So this is ISO 50. This is isometric 50. I have to draw it here and also on this axis because both are equal. Now I got the point P here, Q here, and S here. Now to complete, I have to draw parallel lines. Now as this is a isometric projection of a square shape, this point and this point, this is point R, will be on the vertical axis exactly. That is one check you can do. R should be vertically aligned with P, because it is equal sides. Now, isometric projection of a circle is an ellipse. And in order to get ellipse here inside this box, there are different methods. One of the method is called four center method. We will use this four center method to construct the ellipse or fit the ellipse inside PQRS now. First, join S and Q. Then, identify the midpoint of PQ and PS. To identify the midpoint of this line, we should mark ISO 25 here, because the total is ISO 50. This should be ISO 25. So let us mark 25 mm here, ISO 25. So ISO 25 I am marking, and take this ISO 25, draw it from this point and from this point. You got the midpoints. So one of the midpoint is here, midpoint of PQ, midpoint of SP is here. Now, as second step, you join R and this midpoint, and R and this midpoint also. Now you can identify four centers for drawing four arcs and which will eventually make an ellipse. First one is this point. You can call it as C1, center 1. Second one is this point, which you can call it as C2, center 2. Third point is this, which you can call it as C3, center 3. And fourth point is this point, which you can call it as C4, center 4. So these are C1, C2, C3, C4 are the centers for drawing arcs now, which make the complete ellipse. Observe how I do it. First, you consider center as C1. Start point of this point, this midpoint, this should be the radius of the arc. This should be the radius of the arc. And draw an arc like this till this midpoint. It joins this midpoint and arc is drawn here. This is one of the arcs that you need to draw using point C1 as center. Now as C2 as center, with the same radius, C2 as center with the same radius, draw an arc here. This is second arc with C2 as center with the same radius as we have drawn for the first arc. Now C3 as center, but radius will change now. This much as a radius, C3 as center, this much as radius, you draw this arc. This is the third arc. And C4 as a center with the same radius, you draw this arc. Now you got the ellipse. This is the isometric projection of the circle of diameter 50. Now you can darken this to complete this projection. This method of construction is called four center method. This method can be used for vertical planes also. This is drawn on horizontal plane.